Worries. What we were talking about, like you know, we were developing a cricket scorecard. Okay, so what we do there is like you know, so we did it very statically, though it looks like dynamic. It's so much of static content over there. So you can find it in the assignment section of yesterday's class. You know how it looked like. Now today, what we do is we talk about super globals. We talk about super globals. What exactly are super globals? And from that super globals, we pick what is useful to us for today's class. Okay? And start giving the score from a form. Okay? So what we do is like yesterday what we have done, we have taken a associative array and printed it right there. Right now from today what we do is like we make it more dynamic. Like you know, how do we submit values from a form to the server and display them as a scorecard? Okay? Fine. So now super globals. What are super globals? Super globals are super global variables actually. Super global variables. Variables. Okay, PHP has several super global variables. Okay, I won't be talking about all of them. I'll be talking about what we really need. Okay, so the first and foremost variable is the server variable. So every super global variable is a associative array. Okay, remember this. Every super global variable SGV, okay, is an associative array. The first is dollar underscore server, the next is dollar underscore post, dollar underscore get, dollar underscore session, very very important, dollar underscore cookie, somewhat important, dollar underscore files. Important when we upload files. Alright? So now I'll just brief, a little brief. Dollar underscore server. This associative array has server information. Okay? Server information. So I'll just show you guys in an example. Okay, I'll show you in a program what exactly this associative array has it. Okay, it's they say server information, but since we are using local host, okay, local host is a server installed on a local system. So in local host we may not get that much of information, but when you guys get your domain names, the first thing you are supposed to do is do whatever the program I am doing here, upload it there and check it out. Alright, dollar underscore post. Now, do you guys remember in form there is a method? Do you guys remember method? This is the most important question. What are methods in form? What is the default method? What are the differences between methods? And when to use which method? Any idea? Form method. No? Yes? Get this default method of form. Excellent. Get and post. Great. Good going. So you know, right? Get and post. Now tell me. Guess it. What does dollar underscore post do? What does this do? Guess it. Wild guess. No problem. No? Now today's class I will tell you guys how to look for a password of an encrypted website. Okay, I hope most of the guys will be excited to know others' passwords. Can we access more data from excellent PostGIS for secure transaction? It will not expose data in URL. Excellent, excellent. Great, good going. You guys will definitely pass an interview. Trust me, if you go for interviews. Right? So, darkness core post. This associative array again. This is an associative array, right? Associative array is used to access, okay, post data. So, if a form has a method post, and if we submit it, we have to collect the information, right? However, the purpose of forms is to submit information to server. So, in order to get that information, if the method is post, then $_post is used. Alright? So, what does this do? This associative array is used to access get data. Okay, this is used to get data, and this, the most important of all, this is used to maintain sessions in the website. So why sessions? We'll talk when we discuss about sessions. Okay, the most important, at least once we'll be using sessions in any website. If there is a session, okay, I'll tell you what all we'll be using. We'll be using this. How do I do this? Okay, we'll be using this. Now you guys tell me, give me an example where get is used, where post is used. This is used to store information from server on browser. No answers? Give me an example. This is used to access files and process them. Oh, am I disturbing you guys to answer it? I'll stop then. Okay, now tell me, give me an example when to use get and when to use post. Now, example, I don't need definitions. A crude example. Tell me which websites use get, which websites use post, or what kind of websites use get and what kind of website use post. You guys have the answer already. You guys told me the differences. The answer is in the differences only. Nobody's here to answer. Nobody? No? Rajesh has an answer, it seems. No? Ankush, no? Tawfiq, no? Okay. I don't know what it is called, but this is, what I say, I don't get the word. Security websites to use post method. Exactly. So now what are security websites? Have you ever observed login forms? PayPal is secured, exactly. So, instead of phrasing this, I will tell you when to use get. Whenever there is a search button. Okay? Whenever there is a search button. Okay? Then, that form uses get. Whenever there is secure data, so there is, this data is not secured actually. You can still see, that's what I'm gonna show you guys today. Even if I use post method, I'll tell you where to look for these passwords. You find a friend system, okay? If his Facebook is open, let's say, you can go there and I'll show you guys how to see his password. His password will be literally visible. But I don't know if you guys use it for hacking. I don't care. I want my students to know everything. Are you up for it, or we don't need that? Whenever there is secure data to be passed or files to be passed. Views post. Okay, this is something like, you know, you have to memorize this, like, you know, when to use what, because it's very important. You cannot use a get method for a login form, and it is not advised to use post method for a search bar, or not just search bar, anything which is, you know, you see these emails, whenever you click something in emails, it has get data every time. The data is passed via URL. It doesn't mean that it's not secured, but that's the only way you can do that. So that's where, like, you know, emails use always, the links in emails always use what I say get data. Alright, so now let's first see post and get. I'll show examples, then we will carry on with our cricket scorecard application. Alright, yes, okay. So I'm gonna share my screen here. So this usually, okay. Oops, I don't know how to move this. Oh my goodness. Okay, let that be. So we'll see examples of get first. So this is, I hope you guys can see my screen, right? I'm using a new interface actually today. So just to try, no. Oh, you cannot see my screen, Rajesh? Rajesh, you cannot see the screen? Taufik, you can? Anybody else have the problem? Okay, great. Anybody, Siraj, do you have the problem? The same problem? And I guess Jinesh can see it. Fine, let's see. Let's see one example here. Oh, this is nice. Great. I like this. What is this? Oh, this has status also. Good. I don't know. This is, I'm a new tool. This is just, I'm just using today. So I'll close these files, the previous files. So we start from HTML every time. Doc type HTML. HTML. Head, body. So here, okay, let's use, we have a form actually, okay, if you guys can remember, I have sent the link in today's class. Okay, we have a message here. This is nice. Great. So yeah, we have a form actually in our older classes. So I'm gonna go there. I don't know what to do with this. So it is in Tutos Live. I don't know, maybe this. Let me just check. I'll close this everything here. Actually, the forms are styled. No, they're not styled actually. We don't want that. We want style files. So in jQuery we have that, I guess. Yes, jQuery validations. Right, this is a file. Fantastic. So what I do is, like, I just copy this file instead of writing the whole thing. I'll paste it here. So what I say here is post, or okay, let's you see post first now instead of get. Post.php. Alright, so I have to copy files here. We have scripts and styles in there. Okay, so we have to copy that. So I'll just copy the whole all of the folders. So htdocs todoslive underscore php and I'll copy it here so they get automatically updated. I'll go to my browser here, I'll close everything here. Alright, it's getting copied. Let's wait. So I'll come back to class here. But there's nothing happening. I can see it from here. So how's your day, guys? Good, bad, hectic, enjoying? How's the day? Hectic. Good. Newest Taufik. Taufik is at home. He might be enjoying. I don't know about Rajesh and Jinesh. How's your day, guys? Very good. I know the figure at home. You'll feel. Jinesh, bad? Come on, this cannot happen. What happened? Why is it bad? So bad? Goodness. I know Siraj, I know. But how was your day? That's what my question is. You feel any difficulty? Okay. I know you feel difficulty, no problem. We start a new class. Most probably in the morning. I cannot anymore handle classes at night. So most probably we'll have a class in the evening maybe. Good news is that I'm out of my job. I'm building a tool, an entire tool for Tutos Live. So I'll be completely free. So I can handle even 4 or 5 classes a day. Yeah, sure. Okay, let's see. So yeah, our files are copied. So how do we do? Localhost. Let's see if our server is on or not. It might be off because I turned off my system. Okay, great. So yeah, it's on, no problem. So localhost todoslive.php, sorry, not dot, underscore php. So we have files here. Our files are these, where is post.php. So this is our form. Alright, so I even put validations over there. So if I say sign up, it says this field is required, this field is required. Okay, so let us style this a bit. This is what happens every time. Why did this come down? Oh no, it's crazy. So oh no, okay, let it be. Our class is not about styling the forms. We have already discussed about styling the forms. Okay, now let's see. So there are two things to remember here. The first thing, in every form, okay, there are two things to remember. One is method. What method you are using? Are you using a post or are you using a get? So the default is get. If you don't use any method over there, if you do not give a method, the default is get. So the next is action. Okay, action is nothing but, okay, to which file you want to submit this form. Alright, so these two things are, keep in mind these two things. So these two things will guide you in submitting the forms. The method you use to submit the form and to which file you have to submit the form. Okay. Now let's see, let's go back to our form here. So this is our form. The method is post. Okay, the method is post here. So when the method is post, What is the super global to be used? If the method is post, what is the super global to be used? So I'll say action. I give action blank. When I give action blank, whenever the action is blank, oh, nobody is answering, nobody knows the answer. Great. When the action is blank, that means submit to the same file. Submit to the same file. When action is blank, whenever you see action blank, it means submit to the same form. Usually people use action equal to server super global, which we will be seeing most probably if time permits, we'll see tomorrow. If not, we'll see tomorrow. Sorry, we'll see today if time permits, or else we'll see on Monday. There won't be any classes on Saturday and Sundays. Won't be taking classes on Saturday, Sunday, Sundays. It's absolutely free for you guys. You can do anything you want. If anybody wants some assignments, or if anybody wants to contribute, yeah, I'll help you guys. Because Saturdays and Sundays, I'll be coding and spending time with my family. Okay? So, sometimes this is action. So, now let us use action blank. We used action blank. Now, I'll put a question to you guys. I'm stopping this. So everybody answer this question. I'm giving all right, answer this question. Good. Getting some nice answers here. Okay. Okay. My goodness. Nice. Taufik is left to answer, and Sumalata. Sumalata is gone long back, I guess. Yeah, she's gone. So Taufik is gone too, I guess. So what's which print statement is used to test array data? Okay, nice. So the answer is number 4. Okay, for each is used not to print actually. It is used to loop. How many print statements do we have? We have 4 print statements: echo, print, print underscore r, var underscore num. I mean, we have so many others too, but yeah, these things are very important. So print underscore r is used to print an array data. Yesterday we have seen it even in the notes. If you guys have downloaded today's notes, it is in there. You guys are not following the notes. Good. So the answer is number 4. 5 is used to loop. Okay. Looping is different and printing is different. Yesterday we have seen for printing, we have seen echo to print individual elements. That is not complete array. Okay, so fine. No problem. So, okay, since this is submitted to the self. Okay, what I do is here at the bottom. Okay, at the bottom, I'll start my PHP code. At the very bottom, if is set, okay. Now instead of is set, okay, let's use this. Let's test the data. I'll write this at the top instead of bottom. So where do we write? We write here. PHP Oh, screen share. I'm sorry. Yeah. Yeah, I hope the screen is visible now. Yes. Visible? Okay, great. So what I do at the top, okay, we have to use pre statements. Pre will format. Pre is nothing but pre formatted. That's it. Nothing so special. So I say print underscore r, which super global is used to process post data. You did not answer this question yet. Which super global variable is used to access post data? Dollar underscore get or dollar underscore post? Now this, nobody will give a question like this except in Kon Banega Karudpati. You won't find questions like this. Now tell me, who is winning? Dollar underscore post. It should be capitals. Okay, remember, it should be capitals. It's not small. All caps. Okay, it's dollar underscore post. Nobody's answering. What happened? Everybody is sleepy. I hope so. I don't hope so, actually. I'm sorry. So yeah, we'll see. Just, I'll print that array. Nothing else. I don't want anything from there. I just will print the array. And now let's see what we have here. So here, I refresh. You see here, it's an empty array now. Okay? So here, I'll start writing something. Sagar@2toslive.com. Password is 123456. Oh, it's at least 8 characters. 78. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. My name is Sagar and my age is 18, and I'll just sign up. Okay, just check it out. As soon as I hit sign up, you see, this is what I have submitted. Okay, this is what I have submitted. So how do I get values? Dollar underscore post. Now if I want email only, Ankush will answer this. If I want only email from this, how do I do it? Just type it. No problem if you make it wrong. It, you will remember it forever if you make it wrong. If you make it right, you will remember forever. Tell me. I need only email. I need only email keys. Now which key? What is that key? No problem. Tell me the answer. No idea? Okay, now tell me, what are the keys and values here in this array? What are the keys and values? What is the first key and its value? Anybody can answer now. Exactly. Great. You got it. Email as key. And so now if I want only email, okay? If I want only email, I'll just remove this. Okay? I'll say echo okay, I'll say echo dollar underscore post. I need only email. Email. Okay, I need only email. Now let's see. This should throw an error. Okay, it throwed a notice saying undefined index. This is a mistake most of the beginners make. Everybody will get this error at one point or the other time. So what is the problem here? What it says, since there is no post data now. Now when I submit it, let that be error. Let that error be there. Again, I'll start submitting the values. Sagar@tutorslive.com 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 Sagar. And now this time my age increased to 21. Now you see that error. What happens to that error? The form is not submitted previously, hence that error. Now submit the form. Now I got the email. Alright, now I have the email here. Alright. So what was the problem before? Previously I did not submit the value, hence it could not find that value. So how do we check if a value is present or not? In PHP, there is a built-in function called isSet. If isSet of dollar underscore post. So whenever I post, okay, whenever I post, I have to check first if the post variable is set or not. If it is there, then print. Now let's see if we get the same error or not. Okay, it says post is there. Now here I'll do email. Thank you. Let's see. Now there is no error. Okay, so isSet of dollar underscore. Whenever the email is set, remember this isSet. isSet is used to check. isSet is used to check if the variable is set or not. Set means declared or present. Okay. Now let's submit now. tutorslive.com 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 9, 8 Oh, password and confirm password must match. So this is jQuery validations, guys. That's the reason I asked you guys to check the class before coming to this class. So jQuery validations are important too. So go through that class. It's very simple. You know, it's very easy to master also. Go to that class and check the class for jQuery validations. So name is Sagar and this time my age is increased again 3 years. So yeah, Sagar@tutorslive.com. So I got the email now. So this is how post values are submitted. Okay, this is cool. Now fine, great. Now how do we get values? So what I do, I'll just comment out this and I'll change the method. I'll use get. Alright, now I'm using get. Oh, I did not show you guys, right, how to check the values. You want to know how to see the passwords of submitted forms in post? Yes. I know. Okay, it's via Firebug. Inspect element with Firebug. Use Firebug. Now coming to here, net. You see this net? Click on net. Okay, resubmit the form. Or usually, yeah, let's see. So it says, do you want to resubmit? Yes, I want to resubmit. You see here, post this URL, click on it. Here there is post, click on post. You see this password? This is password. Alright, this is how. Even this is not secured. People say post is secured. No, It's not absolutely not secure at all. Anybody can see those values. Now, sometimes people will leave their email and remember me. Do you guys remember me? You know how to see that? It's even easier how to. I'll show you guys how to hijack a session. Like you can completely log into somebody else's Gmail. You know, that's called session hijacking. It's a concept. You can Google. I'll type it here in the class. I don't know if I can teach you guys all this stuff. It is called session hijacking. This is how people hack passwords. Now, sometimes you see, you will get emails. Your friend on Facebook, you observe like people will be posting crazy things. Okay, it's not them. Somebody else hijacked their session. Okay, this session, whatever I told you guys, right? This session, when I say session, using this session. Alright, somebody hijacked this. I will tell you guys how to do this. This is really crazy and easy. You can log into anybody's Gmail. You can log into anybody's Facebook. Unless and until, like, you have to get that session. So, session hijacking. And that's not legal to hijack sessions. That's completely illegal. But you have to learn it so that you won't be under that attack. That's the only reason. It's called ethical hacking. Okay, fine. Let's see get. So again, what I do, same process, pre php echo, sorry, print underscore r, this time it is dollar underscore get. Alright, let's see what happens. Now post, there is nothing over there. So I'll just close this. So here again, Sagar, I have to refresh this because we changed it. So I'm refreshing this. See, now empty array. Okay, because I did not submit any value. Oh, email. tutoslive.com and password is 12345678912345678. Name Sagar, and this time my age is 26. You see, this is now get. There is no change except that the method is changed, and you see in URL, everything is in the URL. Everything is in the URL. So that's why get is not, when you Google, let's say, okay, I go Google. Google is a search engine. I'll search for Tutos Live, let's say. Okay. You see here, it's passed in URL. I'll say, what do you say? Yeah. Tutos Live itself, that's fine. Or, how to, you see, Google is crazy. How to use website, how to work in startup, how to kiss, how to lose weight, oh my goodness. So how to hijack a session PHP. So PHP session hijacking, it says. You see, Google, it passes in search engine. Since it's a search engine, it passes. Now instead of doing all this, so typing there, I can directly type here Tutos Live and goes there. You see that? So that is it. Okay, so yeah, search engines use get method. So that's gathered. So if I want only age, now tell me who answers this. Maybe Jinesh, or let's ask Siraj. Siraj, how do I access age only? If not Siraj, Rajesh, cool. How do I access only age? Am I going slow here? Do you guys want me to run fast? It's okay. I want other person's views also. Because I really go slow until unless you understand. You know, you have to get the complete value. We all have time. Only me don't have time. Okay? I don't have seriously time. But it's only for you guys. Alright? So yeah. Absolutely right. Rajesh, you are fantastic. Great. Dot underscore get of age will give me age. Now that you guys know how to, you know, take these values and stuff, right? So shall we go into our PHP scorecard, cricket scorecard? Let's do our scorecard. Okay, I won't put any validations on the scorecard. You have to do validations. Now this is again another assignment for you guys. You have to do jQuery validations. I don't know how you do. You watch the class or you Google or you do anything. Get that done. If you feel very hard, yeah, then I'll explain you guys how to do jQuery validations on that form. So I won't be doing any validations. Okay? So one more thing I'll be telling here. You see these values are submitted via URL, right? So any URL, this is just a URL. Any URL separated like after this, anything after question mark is called a query string. This complete thing, I will type it in the class. Okay, I copied that. I'll stop the screen share because that's so here. This is called a query string. Okay, so you see in Gmails, when you click on something, you know, you find this thing after question mark, there will be a URL, whatever the domain address, then a question mark. Anything after question mark is called query string. So even query string also accessed by dollar underscore get. Whatever which is passed via URL is accessed via dollar underscore get. Now if I want this value, let's say password, if I submit some values via URL and if I know the keys, then this is as simple as that. If I say dollar underscore get of password, this will give me the password. So then I will do whatever I want to do with that information. Okay, let's see now.